Welcome back, savvy savers and financial freedom fighters. In today's video, we're slicing through the numbers to uncover a truth that your bank might not want you to know. Strap in, because we're about to expose why a 30-year mortgage could be the invisible chain that's holding you back from achieving true financial liberation. Think a 30-year mortgage is your ticket to home ownership bliss? Think again. With a web of interest payments that can double the price tag of your home, and an equity buildup slower than a snail in a salt trap, there's more to this story than meets the eye. Join me as we dive deep into the world of interest rates, investment opportunities lost, and the psychological cost of a mortgage that outlasts your car, your gadgets, and even some careers. Say goodbye to the illusions and hello to the hard facts. Whether you're a first-time buyer looking to refinance or somewhere in between, this is one video you can't afford to miss. Get ready to arm yourself with knowledge and take the first step towards financial autonomy. Because here, we don't just dream about financial freedom. We chase it. We catch it. We live it. The 30-year mortgage myth. Unlocking the chains of long-term debt. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and buckle up. Your roadmap to financial savvy starts now. The dawn of long-term mortgages, changing the landscape of homeownership. It's first important to understand the foundation of the banking system we see today and how they knowingly take advantage of your ignorance, openly insulting you by giving you a lollipop formerly called a sucker when you visit the branches. Now let's dive in. Before the 1930s, home ownership remained a distant dream for the average American. Mortgages were typically short-term, not exceeding 5 to 10 years, with a sizable balloon payment concluding the term. Interest-only payments were the standard, putting permanent ownership out of reach for many. It wasn't until the Great Depression that the modern concept of long-term, fully amortizing mortgages came into the picture. With the catastrophic economic downturn, banks collapsed and housing markets crumbled. The government had to step in to revive the failing economy, stabilize banks, and make housing more accessible. This intervention led to landmark changes in the banking and housing industries. In 1932, the Federal Home Loan Bank Act facilitated the creation of a network of federal savings and loan associations, which played a pivotal role in promoting home loans. The real transformation came with the National Housing Act of 1934, which established the Federal Housing Administration, FHA. This move fundamentally shifted the framework for mortgages. The FHA didn't provide loans directly, but insured long-term mortgages issued by qualified lenders, protecting them against the risk of borrower default. This government backing made banks more willing to extend credit over longer periods. Crucially, it was in this era that the standard for 20 and 30-year mortgages was set, providing a way for more Americans to buy homes without prohibitive down payments or balloon payments. These long-term amortizing loans included principal and interest in each installment, making home ownership progressively achievable with every payment. The introduction of such mortgages was a boon to banks and homebuyers alike. For banks, these longer terms meant more interest could be collected over the life of the loan, and the predictable, steady return on loans helped solidify the banking system. For families, the affordable and predictable payments aligned with their financial planning, helping to establish a burgeoning middle class. In 1938, the establishment of the Federal National Mortgage Association, commonly known as Fannie Mae, further cemented the status of long-term mortgages. This government-sponsored enterprise aimed to ensure a reliable supply of mortgage funds by creating a secondary mortgage market, thus standardizing and promoting 20 and 30-year mortgage terms even more. The post-World War II era brought a housing boom, and with the GI Bill of 1944 offering veteran benefits including home loan guarantees, the practice of longer mortgages became even more widespread. The Great Depression began in 1929, following the stock market crash in October, and lasted until the late 1930s. Today, 20 and 30 year mortgages continue to be the cornerstone of the American dream, allowing generation after generation to plant roots with the confidence of a stable, long-term investment, shaping the fabric of the American economy and society. The impact of the introduction of long-term mortgages has been profound, transforming not just the banking industry, but molding American culture itself, nurturing the concept of homeownership as a core component of success and stability. The Great Recession's housing crisis primarily spanned from 2007 through 2009, with the most intense period being in 2008, when various financial institutions crashed, leading to massive foreclosures and the deepest economic downturn since the Great Depression. During the Great Depression, it is estimated that about 1 in 4 homeowners lost their property to foreclosure due to their inability to keep up with mortgage payments amidst economic hardship. However, specific numbers of foreclosures are less precise because record keeping at the time was not as thorough as it is now. Nonetheless, it was a widespread issue that affected millions of Americans and was a significant aspect of the housing crisis during that era. During the decade from 2007 to 2017, which encompasses the period before, during, and after the Great Recession, the long haul, the drawbacks of a 30-year mortgage over shorter loan terms. When venturing into home ownership, the 30-year mortgage often seems like the prudent choice for many. It promises lower monthly payments spread over 3 decades, seemingly making a home more affordable. However, this long-term commitment comes with considerable downsides compared to its 5-10-year counterparts, especially when we analyze the total financial impact. Interest payouts, a tale of compounding costs. A primary disadvantage is the total interest paid over the life of the loan. Take, for example, a $300,000 home with a fixed interest rate of 4%. On a 30-year loan, the total interest paid would be over $215,000. Comparatively, on a 10-year term, even if we assume a lower interest rate due to the shorter duration, say 3.5%, the total interest paid comes down to about $53,000. A startling difference. Equity building, the slow climb versus the rapid rise. Equity accumulation is significantly slower in a 30-year mortgage. Equity is not just ownership, it's potential future capital for investments or emergencies. With longer mortgages, the initial years are disproportionately weighted towards interest rather than the principal. In contrast, a shorter-term loan aggressively builds equity, providing homeowners with more financial flexibility. Interest rates, the long-term, lock-in. Next, let's factor in interest rates. The 30-year mortgage typically carries a higher interest rate when compared to shorter terms. This is because lenders take on more risk due to the uncertainty over a longer period, a risk that's transferred to the borrower through higher rates. Opportunity costs, the investment potential dilemma. The opportunity cost of a 30-year mortgage is also significant. The lower monthly payments may seem to leave room for investing, but the calculation is not that straightforward. If a homeowner opted for a 10-year mortgage, that individual would pay more monthly, but after a decade, they would have no mortgage payments at all. This frees up significant capital for investment, which could have compounding returns that far outpace the saved difference in the initial mortgage payments. Flexibility and life changes. A mortgage that outlasts change. Lastly, a 30-year mortgage may lack flexibility. Life can change in unpredictable ways, and what works for a homeowner now might not in 15 years. Career changes, family expansion, or relocations could make the long mortgage term less suitable. In essence, the preference for a 30-year mortgage may initially appear budget-friendly, but this long-term commitment carries the disadvantage of higher total interest, slower equity buildup, potentially higher interest rates, significant opportunity costs, and less flexibility to adapt to life's changes. As with any financial decision, it is crucial to weigh these factors thoroughly and consider personal circumstances and future financial goals. A shorter mortgage term, while demanding a higher monthly payout, may lead to greater financial freedom in the long run. The long-term impact of a 30-year mortgage can indeed be surprising. Here's a quick look at why that might be. 1. Interest over time. A significant part of the overall payment goes towards interest, especially during the earlier years of the loan. Over 3 decades, the total amount paid in interest can often exceed the principal amount borrowed. 2. Equity building. Equity builds slowly in the initial years as payments are mostly interest. This means if you sell your house earlier, you might find that you haven't built up much equity. 3. Opportunity cost. The funds you funnel into mortgage payments could potentially have been invested elsewhere with possibly higher returns. 4. Inflation factor. The later payments in a 30-year mortgage are not as costly in real terms due to inflation. The money you pay at the end of the term won't carry the same value as when you started. 5. Maintenance and upkeep. A homeowner needs to consider the cost of maintenance over 30 years, which can add a significant amount to the overall cost of ownership. Understanding these impacts helps in making a more informed decision about whether a long-term mortgage is the best choice for your financial situation. I am not a licensed financial advisor, and this video is not for legal advice. Please consult a professional advisor before making any financial decisions. Hit the next video YouTube recommends here, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Until next time, thanks for watching.